In this video, we will walk you through setting up Discord with Elgato Wavelink. If you are new to Wavelink, we have a few videos covering the basics of adding and configuring channels, routing audio, and more. We have these linked in the description. Before diving into Wavelink, make sure to have Discord configured to accept audio from your microphone. You can do this by heading into Discord settings, voice and video, and then changing input to microphone wave. Or if instead of a Wave microphone, you're using Stream Deck Plus, you would choose Microphone FX, which includes some features we'll talk about next. For simply talking to your friends in Discord, you're actually all done. But if you want to apply audio effects to your voice or add in optional sound effects, this is where the Microphone Effects listing comes into play. Now, to add an audio effect to your microphone, below each channel in Wavelink is the Audio Effects button. Click on this button to open the Audio Effects menu, and then the Plus button. You can then choose an audio effect from the list to add. We'll choose Elgato EQ. Once we do, a new control panel will appear. To learn more about audio effects and how to install them, check out our full guide, linked down in the description. Now make any changes you would like, and then close the control panel. Your settings are automatically saved and are affecting your microphone through the microphone effects output on Wavelink, and anyone listening will hear the difference in real time. If you are processing your microphone audio through Wavelink with noise reduction, noise gating, or other filters, you may want to disable some of the extra audio processing inside of Discord. This can be found lower on the page for voice and video. Set noise suppression to none, and disable echo cancellation. Another option is to consider adjusting your voice activity threshold to ensure your voice comes through clearly, as well as any of your sound effects. Next, what if you wish to use a soundboard with your friends in-game? That's where the SFX channel comes into play. This is the only other channel besides your microphone that is able to send audio directly to the same microphone effects output that we talked about before. Expand the options for your SFX channel and check the option Route to Microphone Effects. You can use your Stream Deck with soundboard actions. Just be sure to set the output option to Wavelink SFX. Tap a key and send audio clips to your heart's content. If you use another soundboard app, just be sure to set its audio output to Wavelink SFX to make sure it's sending audio to the SFX channel in Wavelink. You can also route your friend's audio from Discord into Wavelink for mixing, adjusting volume, or even adding effects to their audio for you to listen to or for your live stream viewers. Be sure to set Discord's output device to Wavelink Voice Chat, and don't forget to add the Voice Chat channel to Wavelink. Immediately, you will see that sound coming through into the associated channel. You're now all set up with Wavelink and Discord. Don't forget you can control Discord right from your Stream Deck, joining text or voice channels, push to mute or deafen. Check out our video covering the Discord plugin, linked down in the description. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to us on Elgato Workshop to learn how to get the most out of Wavelink and other Elgato products. Thanks for watching.